Hi guys, Casey Talks EV here. So as I talked about in the previous video, this car has had the January 2021 BMS update. What that means in effect is that the top buffer, or the part of the battery which you can't use, normally use, has basically increased in order to increase the longevity or the overall time the battery pack lasts. I'm not quite sure whether SAIC or MG had found some longevity problems on their CATL cells, for example, other models of car, or they're just playing it safe, but I'm guessing they are experts in that, and I'm guessing it's probably a good call. Now, because they've increased the top buffer and actually, hopefully by extension, decreased the bottom buffer, that means the usable capacity should be roughly the same. On my previous range tests, so you can have a look at them here, so I've done a winter range test and a summer range test. They've both come out to around 42.26 or 7 kilowatt hours. If they haven't really changed the usable capacity, that means that we should see about, well, the similar range from both range tests, and that's why I'm going to be completing one today. Coincidentally, the day that I actually picked, we're having kind of a mini heat wave up here, so the temperature is currently 21 degrees, so it's pretty much on par with the conditions that we had in the summer range test, and therefore the results should be a lot more comparable even though it's still March. On top of this range test, what I'm also going to be doing is I'm also going to be doing a rapid charging test. Now, I would normally do this at the NG charger. I'm actually here at the Aldi in Hesel, because at the moment they've blocked off the chargers at the Ingenie point, which I normally use. I think it's the Red Sails. I can't use that one, and the closest rapid charging point is the one in Hull city centre. This also means that I might be able to avoid some of the roadworks and get a more representative motorway range test. But essentially what this also means is that the charging curve may be also very slightly different compared to what it was previously. So previously you were looking at maybe getting to about 80% state of charge before it would throttle down to 16 to 20 kilowatt. It looks as though when I was looking at, for example, the charge that I did at Peterborough for the Huntingdon road trip, they may have actually increased the state of charge of which it would then start to throttle. It looked as though that it wasn't actually throttling until around 88%, 90% state of charge, and hopefully I might be able to mimic the same test. Unfortunately, as well, the Alpha Power 100 kilowatt charger that I would have used is A, in Leeds, so that's a bit of a trek, and B, I think is actually currently offline. So I think the BP Pulse charger in the Holiday Inn Hull is about as good as we're going to get. But hopefully that should show at what point does it start throttling. So anyway, let's get started with first of all the range test, and then second of all the charging test. Going back onto the slip road, back onto the M62. I've done 60 miles, average speed is 60 miles an hour, 59 minutes and 3.3 miles per kilowatt hour. I've actually went a little bit further. I can't remember which junction that is, but it's the junction with Bradford. Unfortunately, I have hit a bit of congestion, and therefore the smart motorway speed limits have decreased a little bit. They're down to 50 miles an hour, but I think for the rest, well, at some point for the rest of it, it should go back to 70 again. So I think the car's doing all right. I think we just gotta finish the test off by getting back home. So I've just completed the test. So we've done 119.3 miles, average speed of 60 miles an hour, hour and 58 minutes, and 3.4 miles per kilowatt hour. To be honest, the kilowatt hour, miles per kilowatt hour seems to be quite a bit higher than what I'd expect. Even though the average speed for this run compared to the summer run is definitely lower. So the summer one was 65 miles an hour, this one's more 60. I still think 3.4 miles per kilowatt hour is quite high. The reason why I'm also saying that is because when you calculate out the usable capacity, it's around 40.8 kilowatts, which then seems substantially lower compared to the other two results that I've also done. There is a possibility that the actual mileometer itself is calculated in a slightly different way now. It might be, for example, rounding up when it should be rounding down. There might be some inkling on that. The reason why I think that is because when you work out at 3.3 miles per kilowatt hour, you're looking at around 42 kilowatts usable capacity using the same calculation that we've done in previous two tests. I mean, I managed to do 119 miles with 13% remaining, so that sounds pretty good. I think that's perfectly reasonable, to be honest. And even though the miles per kilowatt's slightly higher than what I'd expect, it seems to be, I mean, it seemed to have performed in pretty similar way compared to what it was pre-BMS. So the next test that we're going to do is the charging test. So I'm going to have to make my way to a BP pulse charger. So we've arrived at the BP pulse point. We arrived here on 12%. Unfortunately, as I was faffing around with the camera, we actually got a couple percent in. So I think the phone is currently recording from 14%. We're currently charging 399 volt, 122 amps. So at the moment, we're just going to watch the time lapse pretty much. So we've just currently ticked over 31%. We've managed to go from 12 to, well, just now 32% in just under 10 minutes. We're still taking in 405 volt at 120 amps. So I think that's about, what, 40, 48 point something kilowatt. So yep, still taking the full rate. Okay, so I've just gone in to register my registration plate. Make sure you check whether you need to do that at BP pulse points. So the car's currently on 44%, 12.5 kilowatt hours delivered in 15 minutes and 40 seconds. So we're at 409 volts and 119 amps. So that should be around, well, still about 48 kilowatt. I've now realized that, yep, this phone, the Huawei, does have a time limit. I think at some point I do need to consider getting myself a decent camera and a decent microphone at some point, probably. So if anyone has any good suggestions, please let me know. So we've just hit 50%, 15 kilowatt hours delivered in 18 minutes and 43 seconds. Again, we're still getting 412 volt at 118 amps. So I think every time I'll just put the calculation down on the side as I normally do. But yeah, I think we're charging very well at the moment. Let's see what happens as it gets towards 80%. So we're currently at 60%. Battery cooling actually kicked in at 55%. We're currently getting 418 volts at 112 amps. So we've just hit 70%. Well, just ticked over 71 now. So 23.1 kilowatt hours. 29 minutes, 15 seconds, and 426 volt at 98, 99 amps. Battery cooling is still on, as you can hear. But everything seems to be going fine. Now, let's see whether or not this charger does just tick over as per normal, or whether or not I need to stop it. So, we've just reached 80. And, well, we are getting, yeah, 91 amp, 435 volt. It seemed to have ticked over, I think. Let's see. As I mentioned before, there have been certain polar chargers that have not needed to stop. I'm just really not sure what's going to happen right now. So the Grove Hotel charger charged up no problem at all. The Peterborough charger, though, did need... well, it stopped at 80% and then I was just able to restart the charge. So let's see what happens in terms of the curve. I mean, we've just gone to 81, no sign of any throttle in down. So 436 volt, 91 amp. Okay, so I think at 83% it did actually stop. It's giving me the same warning that you normally get. I can't turn the camera around, but you normally get a big cross. So yes, in this case, it definitely didn't go past. It still has the bug where it shuts off. Okay, so that took a very long time to get it back up. But anyway, it's now back up. We're on 85%. We're getting 434 volt at 74 amps. So I'll put the kilowatt hours here. Now, I think what's going to happen now is as we get towards 88 to 90%, it is going to start dropping as it normally did as it got to about 80, 81%. So let's see what happens. Okay, so I think it's about to start throttling. We're at 90% now. It is slowly creeping down now. With respect to charging speed and charging curves, there has been quite a big difference. Normally, at 80%, it would start throttling. Now we're looking at a 90%, and at that point, it will start throttling. Now, that 10% may not seem like that much of a difference, but that's possibly 10, 15 miles. And if that's the difference between making it to your destination, if assuming they have a destination charger, obviously, or not making it to your destination, to be honest with you, I think any sort of additional range without time wasting makes a lot of sense. What I mean by that is that it's not really worth spending more time at a rapid charger if you're not using it at rapid speeds. The main reason why is because it's just better off to either get to your next charger and then you'll get the full 45, 50 kilowatt speeds. And then rather than spend, 20 minutes, half an hour getting that maybe extra 15%, it's just better off just to go at 80, but now you can go at 90 with an 80% sort of window between 90 and 10%. And for possibly a lot of people, that could be quite profound. So I think in summary, in terms of the range test and usable capacity, I'd say that the range actually is pretty much unchanged. I mean, if you calculate it one way, you get pretty much the same. If you calculate the usable capacity, you get something different compared to the other tests. So it could be potentially just a calculation sort of thing, especially with the miles per kilowatt hour. It could be under reporting or over reporting. So I'd say yes, in post BMS update from January 2021, the range is absolutely fine. With respect to charging speed and charging curve, the speed's unaffected, but at the point at which it actually throttles has changed quite significantly. So instead of throttling around 80%, you're now throttling around 90%. And as I said, that could make quite a big difference depending on what you're doing. But I think that's pretty much it. So if you liked the video or you found it interesting, please like the video. Dislike it if you don't. Thank you, ambulance. Is that ambulance or is that a police car? No idea. Yeah, dislike it if you don't. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. We're on 847 subscribers, which is absolutely amazing. Click on the bell icon to be notified on any future videos. Thank you for watching and talk to you later.